I need your help. You'll be investigating the most detestable collection of people that you will ever meet.
I wasn't really looking for another thriller. I wasn't really looking for another serial killer movie to do. But I love these two people at the center of this thing. I thought they were just truly original. I thought she was unlike any girl in a movie that I'd ever heard about. Steve Zalian had figured out a way to get all 500 pages and find the stuff to milk out of it to make a really compelling adaptation. So there was no reason to say no.
The chance to come and make a movie, whether it's set in Sweden, I mean, that we couldn't have changed that. I think that. We needed that backdrop. It needed to feel European. It needed to feel Scandinavian, more to the point. And the adult themes, I wouldn't have done the film unless we could make it into an adult movie.
Daniel Craig was the first idea off everybody's head, so it wasn't hard to embrace Daniel, and it wasn't hard to contact Daniel. It was hard to schedule Daniel because he's very in demand, and he was, you know, finishing Cowboys and Aliens, and he had a Bond movie to go and do, and somewhere in there we could find, you know, in our case 6 months where we needed to make this movie. That was more difficult than imagining him in the role. I thought he was perfect.
They keep offering me jobs, keep saying yes, so I don't have a plan. I said to myself, if I do Bond movies and that's all I ever do, I'll be happy. So I mean, this is just, I've just been very fortunate that things have kept going and interesting roles like this have come up. The simple fact of it is, I've wanted to work with David Fincher for as long as I can remember, for many years, and so the opportunity to do it arose and I took it.
You know, it was a very long process. I don't know if I would say I struggled. I certainly was very focused and was working very hard and was fighting very hard to get the part.
The person that we kind of put through the most paces, you know, the person that we sort of tortured the most, ended up being the person who wanted it the baddest. And I felt that's the one that I wanted. I wanted the one who wasn't getting a lot of encouragement, who must have been, you know, really depressed time and time again, you know, about having to do this and show up again and try it one more time. And I ultimately felt that that's who Solander would be. She would be the one who didn't quit.
You know, I think at a very basic level, it's a thriller and it's a mystery story and people like those. And then, you know, on a more personal level, I think people can really relate to this character. People can relate to that feeling of being outcast or misunderstood, or you know, they can relate to people who are in a position of power and who abuse that power. And then on top of all that, you know, the books and the movie are about secrets, you know, secrets that people have, secrets that a society have, and I think sort of all of those themes combined just, I don't know, he struck gold.
I think it's the characters. I think they're very well drawn and interesting, and the idea of a character that's been beaten down all her life and has nothing really to give, it would seem, to society, but actually is an extraordinary human being and has developed into this sort of, you know, someone who has a very strong sense of what injustice is, and a journalist who believes in the same things, who believes he knows what's right and wrong, and wants to fight for what's wrong about the world, and the two of them coming together and having this relationship is fascinating.
But it's not a remake. It's another film based on the same book. It's like they're shooting Anna Karenina here in town now for the, what is it, 50th time or something. The big difference is between the big Hollywood productions and the independent films, whether they're American or not. But the American working culture is different from the Scandinavian. In Scandinavia, everybody can do everything on a film set because it's so small crews, and everybody's also involved in the process of making decisions, which means that a Swede, it's not very hierarchical at all, a Swede wants to know why he's going to do something. In America, it's enough that you're told by your superior, do that and you'll do it. But and that, I think, created some friction when they started working with a half Swedish crew and half American crew. Because they want to know, yeah, but why? And they want to be a part of the process to the decision, too. But it was fun. I had one foot in each camp, so I could understand both sides.